IVM.
Hi.
You're
listening
to
IVM
Daily.
Hello, welcome to a brand new episode of IVM Daily. My name is Abbas, and with me in the studio, I have with me Janam.
Hi.
Kartik.
Hello.
Ashish.
Hello.
And that's all. Today, we're going to be talking about social media apps, since we spend so much time on our phones and on our devices and on social media apps. We're going to be weighing on some aspects of social media that we like certain websites, certain social media sites. What we like about this is my fourth attempt to try and summarize what it is. Aspects of social media sites that we like and aspects of social media sites that we dislike. Am I correct, guys?
Yep.
Yes. Yep.
So before we get into that, let me just quickly get a view of what were the first social media site that you guys were on? What about
Orkut.
You, Ashish?
Orkut.
Orkut for everyone.
MSN Messenger.
Oh my God, you just went way back.
Yeah, Stone before Age. Orkut was MSN Messenger. Yeah.
But was chatting the same as social media?
Kind of. I mean, that's how it started, right? The whole instant messaging thing.
But
it was with people you knew, I think. Social media refers to you talk to someone you don't know.
No, social media from
talking people you don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Messenger is like someone you know. Mostly.
Well, for most of us, it was MSN and Orkut. Yeah. But I think I use Twitter and Instagram the most nowadays. What about you guys? How much of your time do you spend on Facebook? Do you think Facebook is like still a thing?
I don't think so.
Yeah, even I barely open Facebook.
When was the last time you opened your Facebook?
Today morning.
I open it, but you never.
Just to check birthdays and stuff.
I don't scroll through it.
Yeah, I guess Instagram. Yeah, Instagram. We scroll through Instagram the most, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think so, Instagram, WhatsApp, and Twitter are more.
Right.
Go to.
So when it comes to Facebook, like, what are the things that you liked about it, and what are the things that made you stay away from it now?
I think Facebook is Facebook. We used a lot of it before Instagram happened.
Right.
Yeah.
And for us, Facebook was like a thing of like posting pictures, videos with a lot of text as well.
Right.
So people had status updates and birthday wishes and writing on each other's walls. But when Instagram happened, obviously Instagram being a more visual platform, everyone kind of migrated there. And now that I feel Twitter, I'll just mention this. For the longest time I was not on Twitter. I kind of, since there was already Facebook and Instagram, I didn't feel the need to be on another app, and I joined Twitter in like 2016. And I've been kind of more active on that now. Okay. I feel for text-based things and for also receiving news, Twitter is more convenient and reliable.
Yeah.
And if I want to go for something visual, definitely Instagram. If I want to go read something, read opinions of people or like funny tweets, I'll go on Twitter. Facebook kind of is somewhere in between, which doesn't really offer me much except random ads.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to get to, that Facebook, when I got onto it early on, we all made that migration from Orkut to Facebook because it was a place to connect with friends, right?
Exactly.
Then suddenly it became about pages. Okay, these are cool pages. Let's follow
memes.
These pages.
Yeah.
But do you remember the early days of Facebook? This is back in 2007, 2008, when there was this feature where you could throw cows at people.
Really?
Yeah.
There were like...
I missed out on that, I think.
There was like...
It was Farmville. Not Farmville.
Before Farmville, you could... There were like... It used to come like... this one threw a sheep at you. This one threw a pillow at you.
Oh, okay.
I know the Farmville era.
I just know that the poke era.
Yeah, the poke thing, which is almost non-existent now. You still can do that, but almost nobody
does that.
No, people do.
People do.
Sometimes it happens like once in 6 months, but I get a poke now and then.
Yeah, and I mean, before you knew it, Facebook was so filled with ads and sponsored content
and games,
and your entire family was on Facebook, so that instantly took away the cool quotient of Facebook away from.
And one more thing I liked about Facebook is you can connect to a lot of people. Like, Facebook is pan world, like it's everywhere. people use it. People
ban
do,
world.
Yeah, okay. I just coined a new word though. So yeah, it's worldwide. Okay, so
no, it's pan world now. Oh, yeah. Too late to take it back, Karthik.
So yeah, you can connect your friends and everyone basically on Facebook. Mm. You still do that.
Yeah. Also, they spy on you. So
yeah, it's pan world.
Yeah. Also, I think Facebook has become this platform which is like for your not that close friends, you know, like people who you don't talk to every day.
Right.
Only people who wish you like once a year on your birthday and be like, hey, how have you been? Or
yeah,
like
also for your family.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It's just I log on to Facebook. I just don't want to know what people on Facebook have to say.
Hmm.
It's just become this, you know, dumpster of let's just say anything we want on Facebook. I'm like, there is no nuance. There is no anyone is saying anything.
Yeah.
There is absolutely no restriction on what you want to say and post.
So, like anarchy.
Not even anarchy. It's like, I don't know. It's just not
You're
funny.
Done with Facebook.
I'm kind of done with Facebook. It's not funny and cool anymore. The messenger sucks. You have to download another app to use the messenger. Yeah. I'm like, screw it.
Also,
I don't want
did you know
that
two messenger apps? There's one, the normal app, and then there's Messenger Lite.
Yeah, I know.
This Facebook Lite as well.
Yeah. It's. So. I don't know where they're going.
Screw
with
Facebook.
This. Yeah.
What about you? You're not on any social media site. But why is that? How have you stayed away from all of that?
I don't know. When in the early days, there was the Orkut. You know, there was like the big boom suddenly.
Yeah.
So suddenly Orkut started to die slowly.
Yeah.
And then people were going on Facebook. They were migrating to Facebook. I found Orkut very bad. I mean, so I did not have a reason for me to go to Facebook.
I
never had the need to, I mean, never felt like I should be on Facebook or in anything, because I used to see my friends doing, like, I remember my friend, I asked him for a favor. He was like, can I tell you two guys? I'm like, what two guys? So I realized it's something to do with Farmville or something.
Yeah.
So then I realized, okay, there are games also on this.
Yeah.
So there's like Criminal Case karke bhi, there was this.
Yeah.
That had a sudden big boom.
Yeah.
Ashish knows about everything, but he's not there on Facebook.
No, yeah. I see people daily, they keep playing Criminal Case like crazy. I'm like, what is wrong with you?
So have you ever joined the app and then decided not to do it, or you never joined it?
Never. I was never on it. Like, not Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook.
I highly doubt that. I think you have a pseudonym under which
we do think that.
Yeah.
No, but I don't know, but I'm quite active on Quora. I don't know that if that constitutes as a social media app.
Yeah.
But
are you someone who... So what do you use Quora for? Are you someone who answers a lot of questions, asks a lot of questions?
I don't ask that many as much as I answer.
Okay.
So, and I like the feed, basically.
Okay.
So funny hai, you know, there's some informative sports.
Right. Yeah.
So I like to read through Quora when I'm traveling or something. So that's the only social media, if that is called as social media.
I think it kind of qualifies, because you still get notifications about someone has answered your question.
So nice. That's the only thing. Other is YouTube, because now I think YouTube also has a messenger now. YouTube also has stories now. Have you guys seen this?
What?
Yeah, YouTube has stories now.
I have no idea.
And people do upload stories on YouTube.
Like, I
that's
know
the worst part.
Stories as in?
Stories as in, so if you have Instagram or Facebook, there's that little circle on the top.
Yeah.
If you click it for, I think, 4-5 seconds, you can see a particular story, and then it goes to the next, and it goes to the next.
I have not seen it on the app also.
Right now, I think it's only for the pages who have more than 10K subscribers or something, they're going to roll it out for everyone.
Oh, God.
And Ashish, have you ever been on Tinder?
No, I have never been on Tinder.
Oh God,
also.
That's bad.
No dating apps also I have ever been on. So,
Abbas?
But like, why? Like, do you think it'll waste a lot of your time, or you're just curious?
Not curious, not interested also. So, let me tell you something. I play a lot of games.
Hmm.
So, when you play on a PlayStation,
right.
So you have to have an account.
Right.
On a PlayStation store. That's like a rule.
Hmm.
Yeah. So, I had to make that account.
Right.
So, it's like a social media for gamers.
Right.
Okay. So I used to get this ping from a guy somewhere in Chandigarh. He used to ping me. So my gamer tag is letters, random letters and random numbers. Because I made it in a hurry. I was in a hurry to play the game. So this guy is pinging me every day. Like, hey, you free. So he doesn't know that I'm a guy or a girl. So he's pinging me every day. Okay. So I'm like, so one day I just give in. I'm like, what's up? I just type what's up. So he's like, are you a guy or a girl? The first question. I said, how does it matter? I'm a gamer. End of story.
Yeah.
So he's like, no, you have to tell me you're a guy. So I said, no, I'm not going to tell you. So he came to the conclusion that I'm a girl. So he said, so I said, I don't care what you think.
Yeah.
So he's like, now do I know you're a girl?
Gamer dating website.
So, and
does he still think you're a girl?
No, sir. I think so.
How many dates have you been on? I should ask.
How many games?
No, so immediately this guy, he tells me, I'm going to send you something.
Oh my God.
Don't get angry. Don't get angry. Yeah. And just tell me what your first reaction to that is.
Of course.
So I said, okay. I knew it would be something fishy. Yeah. And my mother was sitting like right there. And he sent me an image. And the image was loading. So the moment it reached forehead, I knew what it was going to be. Okay. I went back and I said, you're sick. You need help. You need help. So I was like, why the hell are you sending me all this? So I went and I blocked him immediately.
Yeah.
So I was like,
this is a guy who can own a PlayStation. So it's not like he's some, it's a guy who is pretty well to do.
Exactly.
Who can afford a PlayStation and play it. And he's sending on PlayStation.
Yeah, exactly. On a gaming website.
Exactly. And I'm telling him that he started the conversation with like, suggest me some good games. Yeah. I'm like, he's good. He's into games.
He's asking me suggestions and all. Okay.
Then he's like, no.
And that's why, ladies and gentlemen, Ashish refuses to be on any social media platform.
He got traumatized. Just looking.
Because he thought, if this is PlayStation, then I can imagine what WhatsApp is going to be like.
Okay. So that was one horrible experience I had.
That's because you pretended to be a girl.
I did not pretend to be a girl. I just pretended to be a girl.
If you just make a normal profile of yourself being who you are, I doubt you will get.
Were you Angel Priya by any case on your PlayStation website?
No. It's just random letters and numbers. I was in a hurry to play the game, so I just made the account really fast. And so nobody. And I also, I did not have a picture on the profile. So. But
did this Chandigarh guy have a picture on his profile?
Yeah, he did. He was very young. he was like 17 years old. Like, and he was writing all this, I'm 17, I can come to Mumbai to meet you. I'm like, what the hell is your problem? I blocked him and I wrote him. The last message I wrote him was, you are sick, you need help. Go to a psychiatrist immediately.
God.
I don't know how he would have felt if he realized.
Be PlayStation and chill.
If you are listening to this Chandigarh guy, you just turned Ashish off every social media platform. Okay, very quickly. I'm someone who uses Twitter a lot as well. And I joined Twitter in 2009, okay, where Twitter was like this really small club of people, especially the very few Indians.
You're calling it club because you want to feel cool about it.
I know, that's what it was. It was this cool kids club. And if you were on Twitter and you were followed by some, influential people, that was like a really cool thing. We used to have these Twitter meetups in cities. And if you were invited to that meetup, it was like, oh my God, I've like really arrived, okay. And then, since then, it's just been this decline of every Tom, Dick and Harry who is on Twitter. And the discourse, like, when I log on to Twitter, like, the first 6-7 tweets are just people ranting about things like, this is bullshit, why the hell did they have to say that? This movie, oh, it sucks. There is no sense of, appreciating things. It's just become ranting machine. Now everyone, like, there was a tweet, and the funny part is then other tweeters will tweet on those things. So there was someone who tweeted that when I go on Facebook, I'm faced with my family. When I log on to Twitter, I just see people having so much fun and feel bad. Now when I come to Twitter, that's my yard, because everybody's just hating each other and setting things on fire.
Oh, you meant Instagram earlier.
Yeah. What did I say?
You said Twitter.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Dub this part when you see. You are fairly new on Twitter, Karthik, right? Do you tweet often?
No, I never tweet. Like, I don't have followers, so there's no point.
But you have to be active for that. You need to tweet actively.
Or a girl. One of the
two. Yeah. Or be Ashish and pretend to be a girl.
Like, I've been on Twitter for 9 years and I've got like 1700, 1800 almost now with a lot of hard work.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Like,
over 9 years.
Not
Abbas,
bad.
Abbas, how to improve your followers? Like, how to increase
get
your followers?
Get comedians to follow you. Like, once I started
Abbas,
doing...
please follow me.
Huh? I do, I think.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
But still, I just have 10 followers.
Guys want to know a secret? Yeah. Ellen DeGeneres follows me, guys. Yeah.
I think
see
that, said
hear
this,
that silence?
You've said this. I've heard this before in
yeah.
some episodes.
In the very, very early days where Ellen used to follow all her followers, I happened to be one of the ones she followed back.
And she didn't unfollow after that.
No. Yeah. I mean, if she's listening to this, Ellen, I appreciate your follow. Please don't.
But I mean, you're right. Twitter has become this like very mean platform.
Yeah.
Like that's why we have these mean tweets.
Yeah.
Celebrities read and
there's so many celebrities who've quit Twitter because all they had was like this barrage of negativity on them. Yeah. So yeah, for now, I think the reason Instagram sort of does well is because you see pretty pictures. Like, there are very few with words. It's like you can put out harsh or mean words, but what is a mean image, right? You can't post a picture of someone slapping someone unless it's a meme.
Also, I think one of the reasons Instagram has this slightly like more positive
vibe
to it is because of the heart. Every time you like a picture, it's a heart.
But so even on Twitter, if you favorite a tweet, it's a heart.
Yeah, but if you remember, that happened
recently. Yeah.
Before, a heart used to be a star.
Star, yeah.
It was a star. And Facebook only had the like button first. But after Instagram had the heart, then it introduced like other
But Facebook
reactions.
Owns Instagram and WhatsApp.
Now.
Yeah.
Earlier it didn't,
I think people wanted a dislike button. There's still no dislike button, but then they give those range of emotions of sad, angry, happy, and what else? Angry, happy.
Whoa.
The heart emoji.
Right.
Do you remember the BBM? BlackBerry Messenger.
I never had BlackBerry, but
Is that considered a social media?
I guess it's closer to what it was like WhatsApp before WhatsApp, where people used to post on Facebook, my BBM pin is this, hit me up or whatever.
And you had the option of like accepting or rejecting a request. And you had like status updates and...
But you guys remember how WhatsApp became like really big was because people wanted to avoid paying SMS charges.
And the limit of 100 SMSs per day.
Exactly, yes. And that's how... And now WhatsApp has caused riots. So that was quite a price to pay to save SMS money.
All your fake messages.
Snapchat. Anybody still on Snapchat?
No.
No, I think...
Did you dabble in Snapchat at any point?
What is Snapchat?
Oh my God. So Snapchat is your... So like I said, you get stories now. Snapchat was the precursor. It was like... It is social media platform... primarily targeted at like the teenagers. So you can only have a story which is for 5 seconds, the attention's, and it deletes itself after 24 hours. The attention span is very less. You have there is no censorship, whatever you film or show. So that's why a lot of adult stars on Instagram redirect you to their Snapchat. I know this because I did research. You dabbled in Snapchat for a while, did you?
Yeah, I installed it and I used it for like a day and I was like, enough. I uninstalled the app immediately. It was quite annoying.
It is.
I still have the app though on my phone, but I hardly used it. I can bet on one thing that I have just posted like 10 photos.
Okay,
that's all in 5 years maybe.
So this whole thing of using filters on your selfies, that comes from Snapchat with dog ears and all this. Then Facebook pretty much took the same idea and put it on Instagram to reach a wider audience. But Snapchat has become pretty redundant now. In fact, I remember I was watching Ralph Breaks the Internet recently, and they had a Snapchat joke, and I'm like, oh my god, like the decline of Snapchat is so quick that when one from the film being into production to releasing, the fad has gone. So now that joke seems so dated. So yeah, but yeah, even I had Snapchat for a while, but now I don't, because all Snapchat features all on Instagram now, so I don't see a point. So yeah, that was our social media junkie report. What we like, what we don't like. Until the next social media app goes big, and we shall have a look at that. Tell us, what are the social media apps you use a lot? What are the features you like? What are the features you dislike? You can reach out to us at IVM Podcast on social media, on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We're not on Snapchat, so don't go searching for us there. You can reach out to us personally. My Twitter handle is at Abbas Momin. Janam, where can one reach you?
You can find me on Twitter. I'm at Janam Devan.
Karthik.
And I'm at Grew Up Mohan on Instagram and Twitter.
Nice. And Ashish is on PlayStation. You can send him a message. Ask him what nice games to play, and don't send weird images.
Yeah.
That was our show. We shall see you on tomorrow's episode of IBM Daily. Till then, bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
Family businesses get a bad rap. At one time, they were looked down on for getting rich, for being too ambitious. Today, they're still looked down on, but for not being ambitious enough. Not agile enough, not modern enough, too traditional in their mindset. The biggest brands and business houses in the country started out as humble family businesses. It's the way India has done business. Join Sonu Basin in conversation with stalwarts of Indian family businesses on the Inheritors podcast series by Bloomberg Quint. Discuss the highs and lows, the needs and pressure points of building a business legacy that spans generations.
Look, up in the internet. It's a meme. No, it's a cat video. No, it's the Geek Fruit Podcast.
That's right. We interrupt this riveting broadcast to tell you about our show, the Geek Fruit Podcast, where Tejas, Dinkar and I, Jishnu, talk about everything in pop culture, including DC, Marvel, Star Wars, Netflix and everything in between.
You know how your friends hate it when you ramble about some nerdy crap and you just want somebody to listen to you? Well, sorry, there's nothing we can do about that, but come listen to us ramble and it'll almost be like the real thing. Kind of.
Listen to new episodes of the Geek Fruit Podcast every Monday and the Geek Fruit Bulletin every Thursday on iTunes, Google Podcasts, the IVM app, or wherever you listen to podcasts. Happy listening, you nerds.